Happy New Year, everybody! Welcome to Kids Worship. I'm Addie.
And I'm Sophia. We are so excited to have you with us today.
One day, Jesus taught on the side of a mountain. Can you imagine what it would have been like to be there and hear Jesus teach?
We call what Jesus taught there the Sermon on the Mount.
Today, we'll hear from Kelly Davenport about what Jesus told the people that day.
Before we do that, it's time to jump up and sing.
Yeah. Great crowds of people followed Jesus wherever he went. One day, Jesus went up on a mountain. He sat down and began to teach about the kingdom of God. First, Jesus taught about the blessings that come to those who follow him. He said, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the humble, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled.
Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs."
Then Jesus taught how believers should live. Jesus said that believers are the light of the world. Let your light shine before others so that they may see the good things you do and choose to praise God. Then Jesus taught about God's law. Jesus did not come to get rid of the law, but to obey it perfectly. He said that to enter heaven, a person can't just look righteous on the outside, like the righteous leaders. A person must be righteous on the inside too, obeying God for the right reasons.
Jesus said, love your enemies and pray for them. When you give to people who are poor, give in secret. And when you pray, don't pray just so that people will hear you. Jesus taught the people how to pray. He also said, forgive others. If you forgive those who sin against you, God will forgive you too. But if you don't forgive them, God will not forgive you.
Jesus said, do not collect treasures on earth. They can be destroyed or stolen. Collect treasures in heaven instead. For where your treasure is, that is where your heart will be also. He taught that God provides for his people. Jesus taught the people many things. When he finished teaching, the crowds were amazed because he taught them like one who had authority.
Jesus taught people what it means to follow him. He taught how people should live, how they should treat one another, and how to love God. People who trust in Jesus live to honor God and show what his kingdom is like.
Hello, everybody. I am so glad that you're listening this morning as we talk about God's holy word. Today, we are talking about Matthew 5-7. Jesus is talking to everyone, Sermon on the Mount. I know you've heard that probably in worship or maybe your parents talking or teachers talking about it, but this is when the large group, they are following Jesus, and he goes on the mountaintop and sits with them and talks with them on how to live while living here on earth. And so today we're going to talk about just a few highlights, but I want to challenge you, chapters 5-7. I want you to read that with your mom or dad or grandparents or friends, and I want you to talk about it. But let's highlight some points. Okay, so at the very beginning, we see Beatitudes. What is that? How to live, how Jesus encourages you. I want to talk about being humble. What does that mean? Okay, I will be honest. I heard the other day over a Zoom call with one of my kids, and this little boy was talking about everything he got for Christmas, and it had to be the best of the best when he was talking about it. I would say that's an example. Remember, let's be humble. Let's be thankful and grateful of what we have. You know, you are blessed maybe academically or with arts or music or sports, but we are not to brag about it. So we are to remember to be humble. Also, another thing Jesus says is to thirst for righteousness. What does that mean, to thirst for righteousness? That means you are longing to glorify God, to live by his holy word. You are thirsting to do the things that are right. Those are the things, and he says, those are the blessed ones who live humbly, who thirst for righteousness, and also peacemaker. I want to talk about that. To be a peacemaker, your goal is to be challenged to love others and to have peace with them, not to stir up trouble or make fun of others. It's a challenge to be controlled with that and not to do those things. And Jesus says, let your light shine before others so that they may see your good works and give glory to the Father in heaven. That is my challenge to you today, is to let your light shine so that others will see a difference in your life and they will be attracted to that light. Thank you so much for joining us today. Let's enjoy this music, and I will see you soon.
There's nowhere you won't go, nothing you won't do, no place that I could hide, you're always in pursuit, I'm never too far gone, always in your sight. in